sema kufiti kahawa turungai wanadai kufiti mashinani nikiwa seti holi. And welcome to this segment where we're talking about the Auris 2007-2012. Now, this is a car that you can actually get in the Kenyan market right about now. But you can join me as we take an in-depth review of this fabulous new car, as you can see, shiny as hell. So join me as we go through it. I'm your guy, Emmanuel Mwenda. Now this headlight is very curvy, looks really good. Now one thing I love about this headlight is that you can get it with xenon lights. And also the fog lights down here come in as standard, so you don't have to buy aftermarket ones and fit them already. Now another good feature that we have for this car is the keyless entry. As you can see, you have the option of coming in with a key, also coming with the keyless knob, and come close and actually unlock it just like that. What I like about this Auris is as soon as you enter, it's a bit cozy, well laid out. The only thing that's a bit nasty or not that good is the fact that all these are plastic. So Toyota might have to upgrade on their feel, how it looks. But if you take a look at it, you'll find that everything is well within reach. The gear, the handbrake is right where you need it. It's a bit funny, it looks a bit funny. But yeah, it's somewhere where you need it. Now, the only bad thing I find when I enter the car is where to put this keyless key. I can't put it here. I don't have a glove compartment. It's all the way over here. And even if I put it here, you may actually go over a porthole and it falls down. But that's also another good feature about the keyless key, because you only need to press the button and it comes on. Now, also another good feature I saw in this car is the fact that the steering wheel can be able to move towards you, away from you, down and up. That way it suits your very many body types that we have in here. Another good feature I saw about is the sun visor with the mirror inside, also the co-driver. The lights are well where they're supposed to be, and for somebody as tall as me, 6'2", you still have a bit of headroom to play with. So that's also a very good feature. And to add on safety, you can actually get this car with 7 airbags, one here, one for the co-driver, another one at this pillar over here, at the other pillar, and two of them at the back for your passengers. Now, as you get into the back of the Auris, you'll notice that it's easy to enter, and somebody my height can be able to have a lot of leg room as well as headroom. And also for the person sitting in the middle row won't feel pressure because it's flush. There's no hump that you usually get to the transmission. It's flush, so it's fairly comfortable for somebody to sit here and enjoy the ride as the third wheel. So you can also pull down that and also get your two cup holders. Quite good. And it has a lot of quite roomy, good headrest though. So yeah, for long distances, this won't really be a problem. So the boot also is large for you to fit in your everyday valuables and also other collectibles. You aren't supposed to see that. Take two. We good? Ah, sir. So there's a lot of space you can actually find. You can fit in almost anything and any wonderful thing that you will also like. Very spacious, as you can see these lights, so that you can be able to find anything in the dark. Also, for added volume, you can be able to fold down the front seats so that you get extra capacity to carry what you need, be it long or big. Now, the most unfortunate thing for this thing is that there's a lip here, so you won't be able to easily be able to carry heavy stuff. And also to say the least. There's also another lip over here that is formed because the seats cannot be able to completely lay flat. So you'll have a bit of difficulty there. So also, I think passengers have a very, okay, they have a lot of space which they can be able to hide their stuff in. For example, this nifty space right here next to the speaker is also a good place to put your bottles and other small stuff, as well as a pocket to put all your documents in. It would be a shame if all we did was talk without any driving. So we might as well hit the road. But before then, I need to tell you, if you're buying a car in Kenya, please make sure the next car you buy is a keyless car. That's the next generation that we're going to. And just like Facebook, you had better jump on that bandwagon. So one of the things I like when I start driving the Auris is the fact that the gas pedal is really soft, so it's pleasant to the feel. Also, the fact that it's so damped, well damped, that you can't really hear any noise coming in. So you are fairly comfortable while listening and driving. Another thing, it's a 50-50 kind of thing. The fact that it has 7 gears or 6 or 5, depending on what you want, it can accelerate, yes, but you won't really feel that punch of acceleration when you foot. Alright, so another thing about this Auris, which is a 50-50 to me, is the fact that when it accelerates, you won't really feel the punch, but as soon as you look at the speedometer, it's doing 100. So, let's see how it goes. Another feature that you should make sure your new Auris has is the air conditioning. Once the aircon is turned on, you can actually get the luxury of getting that crisp cold air that usually comes from an American air conditioning. Very small light there that will light up to show that you drive on eco mode, but that will actually mean you're very light at the gas pedal and you're not really aggressively driving. For example, if I put my foot down, the eco sign will just go off like this. But I would say it's cheap to run. I think full tank is around 3,000 for the date 22nd of May 2016. It's fairly cheap to fuel, also fairly cheap to maintain, because at the end of the day, it's still a Toyota, nothing too expensive. Something if an average guy in the middle class can be able to afford. So what's my take on this car? I've had it for a week and I think the greatest buyers will be the guys who have a family or just starting a family. If not, it just might be that your dad bought this car not for him to drive, but for your mom to drive. But I wouldn't expect a university student to actually drive this car. I'll actually prefer if they actually got a more sportier version. This is more compact, more family tuned and oriented. So please don't hoon in this car. So, you've just watched the review of the Toyota Auris, but I don't think I did enough justice. So, right now I think we'll do the best thing and give it to three geeks who are going to tell us what they think about the Toyota Auris.
Worth killing for, worth going to hell for.